This week on Channel 9 is back, baby. We've got build recaps. We've got WinGet install news. We've got the Super Linter from GitHub, Visual Studio Code updates, .NET 5 preview, and more. Be sure to check it out. Welcome back to another episode of This Week on Channel 9. I'm your host, Christina Warren, Senior Cloud Advocate. And I know it has been a while since we have been here. Microsoft Build was like, a month ago. It is now summer. But there was so much huge news there and so much content that we needed to take a little bit of a break to kind of refresh ourselves. Also, frankly, there were some more important things going on in the world that we needed to focus on. And just a reminder for anybody who is tuning in for the first time in a while, this show is going to be on a bi-weekly cadence until we can return to the studio to do things more regularly. All right, so let's get into this last few weeks' latest developer news. So first up, just kind of a recap. Microsoft Build 2020, as I said, was a month ago, but there was a ton of announcements. There was so much content, in fact, that you may have missed some of it. And so I've got a link in the show notes in the description to our book of news, which just kind of highlights all the big announcements, blog posts, information. I've also got links in the show notes and the description to all the sessions. So if you missed something and you want to learn more, you can check that out. It was 48 hours of live content, like wall to wall. And so if you missed any of the announcements, if you missed any of the sessions, you can catch up now, especially as, you know, some people, if you're in the Western Hemisphere, have some summer vacation time coming up. And I don't know about anybody else, but I love to spend time during summer vacation nerding out about developer stuff because it's great. So be sure to check that out. Next up, one of the big things that we celebrated right before, you know, Microsoft Build was the 1.0 release of the Windows Terminal. And actually now the Windows Terminal 1.1 preview is available. So if you are interested in getting even more of the latest features with Windows Terminal and you want to play with some of the things, like they've got, you know, new ways of being able to, tile windows and different theming options and some other configurations options, check out the blog post that I've got in the show notes in the description, as well as the GitHub page or the Microsoft Store if you want to download like kind of the latest update and check out the preview release. Kayla on the blog also has a really good roadmap for some of the things that are going to be coming ahead in Windows Terminal land. So that's really awesome. And next up, this is really cool news from GitHub. GitHub has just introduced what they are calling a super linter. And so the idea here is basically GitHub has worked with a bunch of different linters that are accepted by a bunch of different programming languages and built it into its GitHub Actions workflow. And the idea is that you can basically, when you're submitting your code for your CI/CD workflows using GitHub Actions, you can check things with these linters to make sure that there aren't going to be any problems. And this can really, you know, cut down on maybe, you know, problems that you might have with builds or with other things. And so this is really great. It's using, like I said, a lot of the really big linter libraries that are already accepted and popular within communities. And it's open source because it's GitHub. So I think this is really great, the GitHub Super Linter. I've got details in the show notes and the description down below for more details on that. Next up, Visual Studio Code 1.46, May 2020 release, is available now. And this adds a bunch of new features and refinements, including the ability to have like GitHub issue notebooks, which will also work. It basically lets you have custom GitHub queries displayed in a custom notebook. There's also now ARM64 support for Windows for the Visual Studio Code Insiders version. This is a really big deal because I know that for a lot of people, one of the problems with maybe looking at some of the ARM-based Windows laptops, things like the Surface X, is that it doesn't work with apps like Visual Studio Code. So the new Insiders build does. There's also pinned editor tabs so that you can always kind of keep your frequently used files handy, a lot of other features. So check out the links in the show notes and the description for more details on Visual Studio Code, how to get it, download it, the GitHub to share any of your issues, or if you have patches that you want to share, whatever the case may be. Great stuff. Next up, this is pretty awesome. So in the new Insiders builds for Windows, there are some really great updates around GPU compute, WSL install, and kind of an update to WSL. And so one of the things that we announced at Microsoft Build is the fact that in future versions of Windows, you will be able to have GPU access within Windows Subsystem for Linux, WSL. And this is actually now in some of the Windows Insider builds. And so this is really great for people who are wanting to do things with CUDA or for machine learning. So if you want to basically be able to have your Windows environment, but you want to use the Linux side to access your GPU to do your machine learning workflows, you can do that. Actually, NVIDIA now has CUDA graphics drivers available for WSL. And so I've got links in the show notes in the description on how you can enable these things if you're using an Insider's build, and these will be rolling out in the coming months to all Windows 10 users. But I think this is really great stuff and just shows how much WSL is improving and how viable it's becoming for so many different use cases. So that's really great stuff. Next up, one of the announcements, and was actually one of my favorite announcements from Microsoft Build, is WinGet, which is a new package manager, command line package manager for Windows. And it's if you've ever used something like Homebrew or Apt or even Chocolatey or Scoop, which have already existed for Windows, this is a similar idea, but the idea is you can install your applications using the command line. And there is a great tutorial that I've got a link to that shows how you can actually use WinGet to install the Azure CLI. So the old process was a little bit more convoluted and it took a few more steps. Now it's actually just typing in a couple of commands, which is really fantastic. So I've got a link to that blog post in the show notes and the description down below. In other news, this is really great. .NET 5.0 Preview 5, as well as ASP.NET 5.0 Preview 5 and the various other .NET have been released. And this is great because there are installers that you can get for Docker images, Mac binaries. There are Snap installers if you're using an Ubuntu or another distribution that uses the Snap format. And this the Entity Framework Core 5.0 Preview 5 is available now as well. You are going to need to be using the latest version of Visual Studio 2019 to use this, but this just gets us one step closer to the release of .NET 5.0, which is kind of going to be the unification of a lot of the .NET things. So I've got details about what is in the new preview release and how to get it in the show notes and the description. All right, next up, this is pretty cool. This comes from my friend and former boss, Tim Heuer, introducing Web Preview. And this is a really great extension for people who are doing ASP.NET web forms, where you can now have a instant kind of web preview. And so you can think about this as something similar to Xamarin's hot reload, where basically you can have the ability to update and kind of preview your web app as you're building it. So this is a really great extension. And I've got details about what this is and how you can install it and use it with your ASP.NET web forms apps in the show notes and the description down below. On Channel 9 this week, we've got tons of great content. Over on Data Exposed, they talk about Elastic Jobs in Azure SQL Database, Part 1. That's a really great conversation. Over on the Visual Studio Toolbox, Robert has an awesome conversation with the man, the legend himself, Scott Hunter, Part 1 of a conversation about .NET. You definitely want to check that out. And over on the Power Show, you can get to know Power Apps Component Framework, or the PCF, in the Power Platform, and Donna talks with Kelsey Bloomquist about that. So you definitely want to check that out. And links to all these shows are in the show notes in the description down below. All right, and now it is time for my pick of the week. Now, I realize that I already made this my pick of the week like a month and a half ago. However, this needs to be my pick of the week again. Basically, the game Cyberpunk 2077 has been delayed until November, but happy birthday to me, I suppose. However, I got my limited edition Xbox One X Cyberpunk edition, and I had to fight very hard to get this. I'm very excited that I got it. It is amazing, and so I had to show it off because it's like the nerdiest thing that I've bought in a really long time, and I'm really excited about it. And it's sold out basically everywhere. However, you can get some of the other accessories like headsets and controllers and hard drives and stuff if you want to build your own kind of cyberpunk Xbox aesthetic. As I said before, I can't believe that I just bought like a console 6 months before I'm going to buy like the new console. But you know what? When it looks this good, I just have to do it. If I hadn't done it, I would have been really mad at myself. So that's my pick of the week. All right. Well, that does it for me this week. If you like this episode, please give us a thumbs up on YouTube. It really helps us out. And while you're there, go ahead and subscribe to Microsoft Developer for all your nerd needs. And in the comments down below, let me know what some of the things you're planning on doing and keeping up with this summer are, as well as your comments on any of the stories that we shared this week. See you next time.